Back in the old medieval periods, there were very elaborate works dealing with magic. Magic, sometimes uncertain, often unsavory in those days. Dark circles at the crossroads, haunts, various forms of black magic. All these finally gathered together under the general term of the astral light. The word itself, of course, is a perfectly innocent word. It really means, essentially, the effects of the stars.
Thank you. the ancients decided or revealed that this energy, which has been locked in misuse, now begins to flow out in its natural purpose. And the nature of this energy is therefore represented by the 12 petals of this flower. And with these petals opening, the victory of this consciousness over the 12 nidanas, which are the conditions of existence, which can all be solved by true love. The victory, therefore, of the chakra simply means that its energy is now devoted to solution rather than to confusion, and that by an experience of consciousness, we have achieved the opening of this flower upon the mysterious rod, which is, we call, the spine. And the blossoming upon the staff is, of course, the symbol of repentance, but most of all, it is the symbol of God's witness that this repentance is accepted, which simply means that the divine power is then moving through these blossoms in its own appointed way, and that pure consciousness is beginning to move out through the neural system, and that as a result of that, the nervous energy thus becomes a redeemed energy, and that which was the betrayer becomes a redeemer. And in the end, as the Persians say, Ormuzd, the spirit of light, and Ahriman, the principle of darkness, are reconciled. And it is in the nervous field that good and evil, right and wrong, truth and error, must make their great struggle and finally be reconciled, because good and evil are brothers. They are both derived from the same energy. They are both supported by the same energy. But enlightenment releases this energy from evil and dedicates it to good. The wheels reverse their motion, and the Dharma chakra, or the wheel of the law that is forever turning, turns towards redemption rather than toward embodiment and towards the Dharma of unfulfilled personal desire.